Yesterday we started some of the important results of adjoint of a matrix. In that we have proved one theorem, that is A into adjoint of A equal to adjoint of A into A equal to determinant of A into I, where A and I are having the same orders and I is additive matrix. According to that we proved that theorem, that is A into adjoint of A, it is equal to adjoint of A into A equal to determinant of A into I. Now we completed already one example by using this theorem. Now today we go for some more examples on this theorem. Now we can take another example, verify that A into adjoint of A equal to adjoint of A into A equal to determinant of A into I, where A equal to 5 minus 2 1 3. Now it is a square matrix of order 2. Now we verify this result by using this matrix. For that I will take first A equal to 5 minus 2 1 3. Now we calculate three results, A into adjoint of A, after that adjoint of A into A, after that determinant of A into I. Now we go for adjoint of A first. Adjoint of A equal to, it is given by direct method. For adjoint of A, we can change diagonal elements first, that is 5 3 changes to 3 5, and second step is change of sign of non-diagonal elements, then this minus 2 changes to 2 and 1 changes to minus 1. Now it is adjoint of square matrix A. Now we go for A into adjoint of A. We multiply A with adjoint of A, we get A is matrix 5 minus 2 1 3 and adjoint of A is 3 2 minus 1 5. Now we multiply row with column, it is given by, it is equal to, first we write 5 into 3 15 minus 2 into minus 1 is plus 2, first row with first column, next 5 into 2 10 minus 2 into 5 10, next second row with first column 1 into 3 3 3 into minus 1 minus 3, after that second row with second column 1 into 2 is 2 plus 3 into 5 is 15, we get it is equal to 17 0 0 17, call this as 1. Now it is first result. Then we go for adjoint of A into A. Adjoint of A into A, first we write adjoint of A. Adjoint of A is 3 2 minus 1 5 and A is 5 minus 2 1 3. Again we multiply these two matrices. Now first row with first column 3 into 5 15 plus 2 into 1 2 plus 3 into minus 2 minus 6 plus 2 into 3 6. Next second row with first column minus 1 5 minus 5 plus 5. Second row second column, it is minus 1 into 2 minus 2 is plus 2, 5 into 3 is 15. Now we get again 17 0 0 17, call this as equation number 2. It is the value of adjoint of A into A matrix. After that we go for this part. For that we calculate determinant of A. Determinant of A is product of angular elements, that is 5 into 3 minus 1 into minus 2, it is 15 plus 2 equal to 17. After that we calculate determinant of A into I, this is equal to 17 into I means 1001. Here we consider order of the identity matrix is second order, because of A is second order. Then we get by scalar multiplication, multiplying every element by 17, we get 17 0 0 17, call this as 3. Now by 1 2 and 3 equations we get all right hand sides equal to 17 0 0 17. Here also same 17 0 0 17, it is also same we are getting. Therefore all are equal, that is A into adjoint of A equal to adjoint of A into A equal to determinant of A into I. It is the verification of the result by using the given square matrix. Like that we prove this one. Take the solution. Now go for similar type of example with third order. Here we verify that A into adjoint of A equal to adjoint of A into A equal to determinant of A into I. Now first we calculate adjoint of this matrix. For that we take it as A equal to 1 minus 1 2, second row 3 0 minus 2, third row 1 0 3. For adjoint we first calculate all the cofactors for this matrix. First we calculate cofactor of A11. So we write cofactors of A. First we write A11. A11 is given by deleting this column and this row. Then we get determinant of elements 0 minus 2, 0, 3. Answer is 0 minus 0 equal to 0. Next we go for cofactor of minus 1, that is A12. It is minus of determinant, because 1 plus 2 is odd number, we get negative of determinant. Deleting this column and this row, we get 3 minus 2, 1, 3. So we get it as 3 into 3, 9 plus it is 2, so it is minus of 9 plus 2 is minus 11. Next we go for third element, that is cofactor of 2, that is A13. It is determinant of deleting this column and this row, you get 3010. So answer is again 0 minus 0, it is equal to 0. Next we go for the cofactor A21, that is cofactor of 3. So it is minus of determinant, because 2 plus 1 is odd. So here it is, I got minus, here also it is minus, because 2 plus 1 is odd number. Then deleting this row and this column, we get minus 1 2 0 3, minus 1 2 0 3. It is minus of minus 3 minus 0, it is plus 3. Next we go for A22, that is cofactor of 0. Now it is determinant of deleting this column and this row, you get 1 2 1 3. So it is 3 minus 2, it is equal to 1. Next we go for cofactor of minus 2, that is A23. Again we write it as minus of determinant, because 2 plus 3 is odd number. Then deleting this column and this row, you get 1 minus 1 1 0. So it is equal to minus of 0 plus 1, it is minus 1. Next we go for A31, that is cofactor of 1. So deleting this row and this column, we get minus 1 2 0 minus 2. So determinant of this is 2 minus 0 equal to 2. Next, A 3 2, that is cofactor of 0. It is again minus of determinant, because 3 plus 2 is odd. Then deleting this row and this column, we get 1 2 3 minus 2. So this is equal to minus of, it is minus 2 minus 6. It is minus 8 into minus 6 plus 8. Next we go for A 3 3, that is cofactor of 3. It is determinant of deleting this column and this row, you get 1 minus 1 3 0. So you get it is 0 minus of minus into minus plus 3. Answer is minus 3. These are cofactors of the given matrix. Now using these cofactors, we find the adjoint of the matrix, that is transpose of cofactors. A33 is 1 minus 1 3 0, it is 0 minus of minus 3, it is plus 3. So these are cofactors of matrix A. Then we go for adjoint of A. Adjoint of A is given by, it is transpose of cofactors matrix, that is 0 minus 11 0. Second row is 3 1 minus 1. Third row is 2 8 3. Now transpose of this is given by, so we can change row into columns and columns into rows. We get 0 3 2, it is minus 11 1 8, it is 0 minus 1 3. Now it is adjoint of square matrix A. Now we hurry for the result, that is we calculate A into adjoint of A. It is given by, first we write matrix A into adjoint of A. A is 1 minus 1 2, second row 3 0 minus 2, third row 1 0 3, and adjoint of A is 0 3 2 minus 11 1 8 0 minus 1 3. Now we multiply these two, row with column. First row, first column, it is 0 plus 11 plus 0. And second row, first row is second column, it is 3 plus 1 3 minus 1 minus 2. Next 2 minus 8 plus 6. Next we go for second row, that is second row with first column, that is 3 into 0 0 minus 0 minus 2 into 0 0. Next it is second row second column, 3 into 3 9 plus 0 minus into minus plus 2. Next second row third column, 3 into 2 6, 0 into 8 is 0 minus 2 into 3 minus 6. Next third row with all columns, 1 into 0 0, 0 into minus 11 0, 3 into 0 0. Next second row second column, 1 into 3 3, 0 into 1 0, 3 into minus 1 minus 3. Next third row third column, 1 into 2 2, 0 into 8 is 0, 3 into 3 is 9. Now by simplifying this, we get it is 11 plus 3 minus 3 cancel 0, plus 8 minus 8 cancel, it is 0. Next it is 0, 9 plus 2 11, plus 6 minus 6 0. Third row it is 0, it is 0, here 2 plus 9 is 11. Now it is the value of A into adjoint of A. Call this as a question number 1. Next we consider second part, that is adjoint of A into A. First we write adjoint of A, that is 032 minus 1180 minus 13 into A is 1 minus 12 30 minus 2 103. Again we multiply these two matrices. Now we get first row with first column 0 plus 9 plus 2. Next first row with second column, it is 0 plus 0 plus 0. Next first row with third column 0, it is minus 6 plus 6. Next second row with three columns, minus 1 into 1 minus 11, 1 plus 3 8, 3 plus 1 3 into 1 equal to 3. Next second row with second column, it is minus 11 into 1 is 11. Next 1 into 0 0, 8 into 0 is 0. Next second row with third column, it is minus 22 minus 2 minus 22 minus 2 plus 24. Next third row with first column, it is 0 minus 3 plus 3. Third row with second column, it is 0 0 and 0. Now third row with third column, it is 0 plus 2 plus 9. So again we get it is equal to 11 0 0 0 11 0 0 0 11. It is the value of adjoint of A into A. Call this as equation number 2. Now we go for finding the third part of this example, that is determinant of A into I. Now we go for determinant of A. The determinant of A equal to 1 minus 1 2 3 0 minus 2 1 0 3. It is Q and S. First we change sign, plus minus plus. First 1 into determinant, that is deleting this column and this row, you get 0 minus 2 0 3. Minus into minus, plus 1 into determinant. Deleting this column and row, we get 1 2 1 3. Plus 2 into determinant, that is deleting this column and this row, we get 30 10. Now we simplify this, it is equal to, so third row is 0. Now it is for this 0 minus 2 0 3. After 1 we get 3 0 3 minus 2 1 3. After that deleting for this, we get 3 0 1 0. Now it is 1 into 0 plus 0 plus 1 into, it is for this we get 3 minus 2 1 3. 3 into 3 is 9 plus 2 plus 2 into 0 minus 0, we get it is 0 plus 11 plus 0, it is equal to 11. Next we consider determinant of A into I. Determinant of A is 11. I we take it as third order identity matrix, that is 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. Why taken here third order? Because here A is given third order matrix. For that we take identity matrix is also of third order. Then we get it is by scalar multiplication 11 0 0 0 11 0 0 0 11. Now we get determinant of A into I value, that is equal to 11 0 0 0 11 0 0 0 11. Call this as 3. Now by using 1, 2 and 3 we conclude that all right hand sides are equal, therefore left hand side results are equal. Therefore by 1, 2 and 3 we get A into adjoint of A equal to adjoint of A into A equal to determinant of A into I. So this is proof of the result. Take the solution. I go for one important result. If A is a square matrix of order n, then determinant of adjoint of A equal to determinant of A power n minus 1, where n is the order of the matrix. Now for this we use the previous result. Just we have proved that one, proof of this result. Now we know that A into adjoint of A equal to adjoint of A into A, it is equal to determinant of A into I. This already we have put along with example. Now we consider this result. Now using this, first one equal to second, second one equal to third, by using this I'll take adjoint of A into A equal to determinant of A into I. Now we consider this one, that is adjoint of A into A equal to determinant of A into I. Now using this we get, now we want here determinant of adjoint of A. For that I'll take determinant on both sides, that is determinant of adjoint of A into A, it is equal to determinant of A into I. I'll take determinant on both sides. Now we know one important property in previous class, that is determinant of AB equal to determinant of A into determinant of B. Using that I'll add this as, it is determinant of adjoint of A into determinant of A, it is equal to determinant of A as it is into I, is written as determinant of I, because we know that standard property, it is determinant of AB equal to determinant of A into determinant of B. Using this we get this result. Now we consider the determinant of this matrix 3 for right hand side and left hand side. If order of this matrix is 3, then we consider identity matrix is also of the order 3. Now we write it as determinant of A into I. This result, now we have taken adjoint of A into A equal to determinant of A into I. Now I write left side as it is, adjoint of A into A equal to determinant of A as it is. If we consider the third order matrix, then I can written as it is 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. I consider I as third order identity matrix. Now it is adjoint of A into A equal to, by square multiplication we get, multiply all the elements by determinant of A, we get determinant of A into 0 is 0 and determinant of A into 0 also 0. Next row it is 0, determinant of A 0 0 0 determinant of A. This stuff we get. Now we need here determinant of adjoint of A. For that I'll take determinant on both sides. Now I write it as determinant of adjoint of A into A equal to determinant of A 0 0 0 determinant of A 0 0 0 determinant of A. So I'll take determinants on both sides. Now it is written as determinant of adjoint of A into A, written as it is determinant of adjoint of A into determinant of A, it is equal to determinant of A into 0 0 second row 0 determinant of A 0 third row 0 0 determinant of A. This stuff we get because by the result determinant of A B equal to determinant of A into determinant of B. This property we are using here. Now left hand side is adjoint determinant of A into determinant of A. Now we observe that it is triangular matrix at maybe either upper or lower triangular matrix because both sides the elements are equal to 0 above and below the triangular elements. Now if the determinant is of triangular matrix, then we take the determinant value nothing but the product of triangular elements. The triangular elements are determinant of A, determinant of A to determinant of A, three values. Then I write it as determinant of A into determinant of A into determinant of A. Now we get adjoint of A, determinant of A into determinant of A. It is equal to determinant of A whole cube because it is 3 times. Now determinant of adjoint of A written as determinant of A whole cube divided by determinant of A, you take this side. Now it is equal to determinant of A whole rest to 2 because whole cube it is determinant of A, determinant of A for 3 minus 1 it is 2. Therefore we get determinant of adjoint of A is equal to determinant of A whole rest to 2. It is written as determinant of A whole rest to 3 minus 1. Now if the order of the matrix is 3, we get determinant of adjoint of A equal to determinant of A raised to 3 minus 1. In general, if the order of the matrix is n, so if order of A is n, then we get determinant of adjoint of A equal to determinant of A whole raised to, if order is 3, we get 3 minus 1, if order is n, we get n minus 1. So like this, we prove this result by using the previous results. The first result is A into adjoint of A, adjoint of A into A equal to determinant of A into I, and second important result is determinant of AB equal to determinant of A into determinant of B. By using these two results, we get the result that is determinant of adjoint of A equal to determinant of A raised to n minus 1, here where n is order of the matrix, where n is order of the matrix, where n is order of the matrix. Take this solution. Now we discuss this result along with some examples. We proved that determinant of adjoint of A equal to determinant of A raised to n minus 1, where n is order of a matrix. If the order of matrix is 2, then it becomes 2 minus 1. At that time, we get determinant of A. Suppose it is order of 3, we get determinant of A whole square and so on. It depends on the n value. Now, we consider one second order matrix. Example, if you take A equal to 4, 3, minus 1, 2, then we check this result according to this property. Now we write first adjoint of A by direct method. So adjoint of A is given by change of diagonal elements and change of the sign of other two. Then 4, 2 changes to 2, 4, here 3 changes to minus 3 and minus 1 changes to plus 1. Now we get this result that is adjoint of A. Now we consider this left hand side, determinant of adjoint of A, it is determinant of 2 minus 3, 1, 4. Now we get it is 2 into 4, 8, minus into minus plus 3, it is 11. So determinant of adjoint of A equal to 11. That is left hand side. Now we check the right hand side value. Right hand side value is determinant of A raised to is 2. Therefore, here R of A equal to 2. Therefore, write N equal to 2. Then we find right hand side value, that is determinant of A. Determinant of A is, again we write determinant of A is 4, 3 minus 1, 2. It is 8 plus 3, it is 11. It is the value of determinant of A. Now we check determinant of A raised to n minus 1. So n minus 1 means n value, it is 2. So it is 11 raised to, it is 2 minus 1, it is 11 raised to 1, it is equal to 11. Now left hand side value is 11 and right hand side value is also 11. Therefore we conclude that determinant of adjoint of A equal to determinant of A raised to n minus 1. Like that we check the result. If we consider another example of second order, A equal to 5, 3, minus 4, 2. Then prove that determinant of adjoint of A equal to determinant of A raised to n minus 1. Here adjoint of A is given by adjoint of A equal to change of diagonal elements, that is 2, 5, change of sign of non-diagonal, it is 4, minus 3. Now determinant of adjoint of A equal to, it is 2 minus 3, 4, 5. So this is 2, 5 is 10, 4, 3 is 12, minus of minus plus 12, it is 22. And right hand side value, determinant of A, the determinant of 5, 3, minus 4, 2, we get 5 into 2 is 10, plus 3 into 4, it is 12, again it is 22. Then here also n equal to 2 because it is second order. Therefore determinant of A raised to n minus 1, we get 22 power 2 minus 1, it is 22 power 1 equal to 22. Therefore we conclude by 1 and 2, you call this as 1, it is 2. Then by using 1 and 2 we conclude that determinant of adjoint of A equal to determinant of A raised to n minus 1, where here n is order of matrix, that is equal to 2. Take the solution. Next we go for another example. If A equal to, it is 3, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 2, 2, 3. Verify that it is determinant of adjoint of A equal to determinant of A raised to n minus 1. Now we considered here third order matrix. Now first we go for left hand side value, that is adjoint of A, and after that we calculate determinant of adjoint of A, after that determinant of A, and here order of this matrix is 3. Therefore we consider n equal to 3 here. Solution of this: first we go for adjoint of this matrix. A is given 3, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 2, 2, 3. These are elements of the given square matrix. Then we go for cofactors, all the cofactors. First we go for cofactor of 3, cofactors of A. First we go for A11, that is deleting this column and this row, we get determinant of 3, 2, 2, 3, it is 3 into 3, 9, minus 4, it is 5. So cofactor of first element is 5. Next we go for cofactor of 2, that is A12, it is minus of determinant because it is 1, 2, it is 1 plus 2 is odd number, For that, deleting this column and this row, you get 2, 2, 2, 3. So you get, it is minus of 6 minus 4, it is minus 2. Next, cofactor of 2, A, 1, 3, it is determinant of writing this column and row, we get 2, 3, 2, 2. So we get it is 4 minus 6, it is minus 2. Next, we go for fourth cofactor, that is A, 2, 1, it is odd number, again minus of the determinant. Directing this row and this column, we get 2, 2, 2, 3. So it is given by minus of, it is 6 minus 4, it is minus 2. Next, cofactor of next element 3, that is A, 2, 2, it is determinant of, directing this column and row, we get 3, 2, 2, 3. So it is determinant value is 9 minus 4, it is 5. Next, A, 2, 3, again it is minus of the determinant because 2 plus 3 is odd. Treating this column and row, we get it is equal to 3, 2, 2, 2. So we get minus of 6 minus 4, again minus 2. Next, A, 3, 1. That is cofactor of 2, that is 2, 2, 3, 2. So it is 4 minus 6, it is minus 2. Next, A, 3, 2, it is minus of the determinant, that is cofactor of 2. 3 plus 2 is odd, then you write minus sign. Then deleting this column and row, we get 3, 2, 2, 2. So it is minus of 6 minus 4, again minus 2. Next, A, 3, 3, it is determinant of deleting this column and row, we got 3, 2, 2, 3. So it is 9 minus 4, it is equal to 5. Now we get all the cofactors, then we find adjoint of A. Adjoint of A is transpose of cofactors, all the cofactor elements, that is 5 minus 2 minus 2, first row. Second row, it is minus 2, 5 minus 2. And third row is minus 2, minus 2, 5. Now, transpose of this is given by, it is 5, minus 2, minus 2, minus 2, 5, minus 2, minus 2, minus 2, 5. Again, we get the same matrix because it is symmetric matrix. Now, left hand side, it is determinant of adjoint of A. Therefore, we calculate determinant of this adjoint of A matrix. It is determinant of 5 minus 2 minus 2 minus 2 5 minus 2 minus 2 minus 2 5. Now, we find this adjoint and its determinant plus minus plus. First we write 5 into determinant is 5 minus 2 minus 2 5. Here already minus is there, minus into minus plus 2 into determinant of minus 2 minus 2 minus 2 5 plus into minus is minus 2 into determinant. Determinant of this is denting this column and row, minus 2 5 minus 2 minus 2. This step we get, simplifying this we get 5 into 5, 5 is 25 minus 4, because minus of plus 4 is minus 4, plus 2, it is minus 10, minus 4, minus 2. Determinant of this is 4 plus 10, so it is 5 into 25 minus 4 is 21, plus 2 into minus 10 minus 4 minus 14, minus 2 into 14. Now we get 5 1 is 5, 5 2 is 10, minus 28, minus 28, it is 105, minus it is 56, 105 minus 56. Now 5 minus 6, 9, it is 10 minus 6, 4, it is 49. So this is the value of determinant of adjoint of A. Next we go for determinant of A. Determinant of A is given by determinant of 3, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 2, 2, 3. Now we evaluate this plus minus plus. It is 3 into 9 minus 4 minus 2 into it is 6 minus 4 plus 2 into it is 6, it is 4 minus 6. So I get 3 into 9 minus 4 is 5 minus 2 into 6 minus 4 is 2 plus 2 into 2. Now it is 15 minus 4, it is minus 2 into 2 is 4, 9 minus 4 is 5, 2 into 4 minus 6 is 2, 15, 3 into 5 minus 2 into 2 plus 2 into 4 minus 6 is minus 2. Now it is 2 into minus 2 minus 4. So it is 15 minus 8. So it is equal to 7. So we get determinant of A equal to 7. Now the attached value is determinant of A raised to n minus 1. But here n is a matrix of order 3. Therefore here n equal to 3. Therefore determinant of A raised to n minus 1 means 7 raised to 3 minus 1, it is 7 square, it is 49. Then we get both are equal results. Here determinant of adjoint of A, it is also 49, call this as 1. And here we get determinant of A raised to n minus 1, it is also 49, call this as 2. Therefore by 1 and 2 it is concluded that determinant of adjoint of A equal to determinant of A whole raised to n minus 1. Now it is very important for CET and JEE questions. So it takes more time to calculate left hand side, to calculate all the cofactors and its determinants. So for that, if we remember this formula, it is very easy to calculate determinant of A raised to n minus 1 value. Therefore, if we are given this type of any question, directly we go for right hand side value. It is very easy to calculate compared to left hand side. By that, we get number of CET and JEE questions for this theorem. Take this as important and take the solution. Some assignment examples. First one, if A equal to 2 minus 1, 4, 3, you verify that A into adjoint of A equal to adjoint of A into A equal to determinant of A into I. Second result, determinant of adjoint of A equal to adjoint of A raised to n minus 1. Similarly, for the second example, A equal to 0, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 2, 3, 3, 1, 1. Now for this also verify these two results. A into adjoint of A, adjoint of equal to adjoint of A into A equal to determinant of A into I. And second result, determinant of adjoint of A equal to determinant of A raised to n minus 1. Here order of this is 2 and it is order of this is 3. By taking n equal to 2 and 3, verify the second result. Try these two results.